I'm going to show you a series of letters and numbers, and I'd like you to categorize them. What I'd like you to do is say left if the character is an even number or a vowel to send the character to the left side of the screen, or say right if it's an odd number or a consonant to send the character to the right side of the screen. Try it a few times. Getting used to it? Not too difficult, right? Now I'm going to change the categorization a bit, but just for the letters. Keep sending even numbers to the left and odd numbers to the right, but now send vowels to the right and consonants to the left. Most people do a lot worse when you change the categorization. It's a hard task. Especially if I ask you to change again. If I keep changing the categorization over time, you'll probably tend to do equally well in every condition with every set of categorization rules. Chances are you don't have any knowledge that would tell you, oh, vowels and odd numbers naturally go together, making it easier for you when those two are paired than when they're not. In fact, if you did better when vowels and odd numbers were paired together, one might wonder if you did have some association between them, conscious or otherwise. Maybe, for example, you had a set of blocks when you were growing up that always paired vowels and odd numbers on the same cubes, and you played with them during your most formative years of learning letters and numbers. And this repeated exposure of vowels and odd numbers together has caused them to be linked in your mind. If I then asked you, do you think vowels and odd numbers go together better than vowels and even numbers go together? Probably say, that's a very weird question. But because of your history playing with the blocks, you have a mental association between vowels and odd numbers, even though you're not aware of it. Psychologists call this an implicit association. This is a really broad term for any time you have a mental association between things, concepts, categories, groups of people, but you're not consciously aware of it. In the example I just gave, the person had an implicit association between vowels and odd numbers, and we could measure the strength of that association using the kind of pairing task we practiced at the beginning. Decisions tend to be faster and more accurate on this kind of task when the pairs you're choosing between are things that are already connected in your mind. Now, most people don't have implicit associations between certain kinds of letters and numbers together. And if they did, there probably wouldn't be that much social consequence to it. But psychologists have been studying how some implicit associations, those related to attitudes or stereotypes about groups of people, can shape our judgments and behavior without our awareness. This is implicit bias, which has very real consequences for how people interact with each other. Researchers tested whether people would display this kind of implicit bias regarding racial groups. Instead of using letters and numbers, they'd say, send things to the left when we show you something pleasant, or the face of a black person, and then send things to the right if they're unpleasant, or the face of a white person. And then, like before, they switch the rules back and forth to see if people are any better or worse at some pairings compared to others. That study found that all but one of the participants had an implicit positive bias towards white people. This was in spite of the fact that when explicitly asked about their beliefs, most people in the study reported no preference or even a slight preference toward black people. Since that first study, many have been done like it. And a meta-analysis of those studies found that implicit associations indicating a preference toward black or white people predicted actual behavior better than self-reported beliefs did. Knowing about implicit associations and biases can help us understand why some people think we've made great progress in race relations, and many others see that there's still a long way to go. Even though the Fair Housing Act of 1968 made it illegal to explicitly discriminate on the basis of race, it wasn't until just last year that the Supreme Court acknowledged that unconscious prejudices play a role in discriminatory housing practices. Landlords and other people making housing decisions might not intend to discriminate against people of color or low socioeconomic status, but implicit bias can shape their judgments and behaviors in a way that leads to discrimination anyway. The distinction between explicit and implicit biases can also inform our national conversation about police shootings of unarmed black men. Psychologists have studied how unconscious stereotypes might lead to implicit bias using a hypothetical shooting task. In this task, participants are quickly shown a person with an object. Sometimes the person is black, sometimes white. Sometimes the object is a gun. Sometimes it's something neutral, like a wallet or a cell phone. Participants in these studies are instructed to shoot when they see a person with a gun, but not shoot when they see a person with a neutral object. Some studies using this shooting task have found that police officers are more likely to shoot an unarmed black person than an unarmed white person. Implicit bias is something that affects all of us, but the stakes are much higher for police officers who are making decisions about whether to shoot people in the real world and not just on a computer screen. So can anything be done to combat these implicit biases? If they're unconscious, are we really responsible for changing anything? Yes and yes. First of all, you can visit Harvard's Project Implicit website and take the Implicit Association test yourself. It's not perfect, but it can help you begin to understand what implicit associations you have. Also, try to recognize what implicit associations you're bringing to the table when you interact with other people. Did I assume this person is a foreigner, or poor, or good at math? Why? Is it because of their race, or their gender, or their age? How might my implicit associations have shaped my reaction to them? But more importantly, if you want to change your unconscious negative associations, be intentional about pushing your explicit beliefs in the opposite direction. Don't be neutral. Cultivate beliefs that are not based on stereotypes, but on the wonderful and complex humanity of your fellow humans. Push yourself to get the perspective of people who are not like you, to befriend people who are different from you, to hire people who are not like you, to live near people who are different from you. Take a look at the parable of the polygons as well for an example of how pushing yourself just a little bit in the opposite direction can go a long way to reducing some of the negative effects of unconscious biases. I'm Dr. Rachel Sumner. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. This feels right.
You didn't notice, but Rachel was actually carrying those mugs the whole time.
All right. Do you want some tea?